After all those years in the underground, the air of the surface seemed incredibly fresh, intoxicating. But that was not what had caused the crew's euphoria. Our journey finally got a definite purpose provided by the transmission from the government bunker in the Urals. For 20 years, we thought that neither the government nor military high command had survived. Turns out they're still around. Where were they while we were eating each other alive in the metro? We'll have a lot of questions for them once we reach Yamantau, if we reach it. The ruins of our country are under enemy control, according to Miller, and we'll have to fight through to our goal. A small team against the occupation armies? What are the chances that we'll succeed? That we'll get some answers?
Anything off yet, darling? Here, let's warm you up a little bit. So, what do you think our chances of getting to Yamantau alive are? It's the only thing on my father's mind. How to earn his forgiveness, get back to Metro and his old life, the life you had always been running from. And to think, I never believed you. And now I'm looking at this fog, thinking it could actually be hiding our new life from us. By the way, we should be approaching the bridge soon. Damn it! A campfire! People! There are people there! Hit the bridge!
Shots fired! Four bogeys on a trolley!
All hands, report to the bridge! On the double!
Are you alright, Artyom?
Damn! They pierced the cylinder!
How bad is it? Can we move?
No, we're stuck!
Ah, shit!
Damn fog! Seems we ran through someone's roadblock!
Who was it? Uniforms!
None. They were wearing rags.
Just some old farts.
Old farts, huh? That's just the perimeter guard. They could have put anyone there, even women and children.
Do you really think we found them, Colonel?
Well, we can't be sure. I was expecting to run into them much earlier. The trolley is headed towards the bridge. Some fortifications there. This looks peaceful. A village and a church on the water. We need intel. Here, Artyom. I put a mark on your map. Get there and find out what you can about that breach. Taking a prisoner would be ideal. Anna, you cover him.
Yes, sir.
May I go with Artyom too? As backup?
No. Until we figure out our situation, you are not to take a step away from the Aurora. These two can handle themselves just fine. Dermak, when can you get the Aurora running again?
I don't know yet. I gotta check on that cylinder, but a full day at least.
I see. Get to it, then! Spartans, let's prepare the Aurora for a defensive action! Stepan, Damir, get the perimeter!
I'm on
yes,
it.
Sir!
Duke, I need you to recon the immediate area!
Got that, sir!
Idiot, you give him cover from the Aurora!
Yes, sir!
Sam and Alyosha, stay in reserve!
Yes, sir!
Don't forget your notepad, Artyom!
Wait, am I not trustworthy anymore?
I'd tell you if it was the case, Sam. Now, cut the chatter!
Let's go, Artyom!
Artyom, don't forget your backpack. It's a new model, a portable workshop, so to speak. The manual is inside. It doesn't come with crafting materials, though, so keep an eye out for those.
Let's move out, Artyom.
Just be careful out there.
Sure thing. Well, I gotta say, that was one flimsy roadblock.
And those guys? Well, they didn't look like army men at all. Just old men.
Be careful out there. Remember, most of the country has been destroyed or occupied. Even those who speak our language might be enemies, by conviction or out of fear. Got it?
Do you hear that bell? We must have given them a good scare. Maybe they served the enemy, enslaved or something. Going down.
Ha, that was great. Artyom, don't wander off. What would you do if some beast came and ate your wife? Other.
A boat! You won't have to go swimming after all. The locals probably get around mainly by boat. Okay, Artyom, I'll climb up there while you take the boat to the church. I'll call you when I'm settled.
Break a leg.
Our father, Silanthius, has already started his sermon. Just enter the temple and see the light of truth. We are a peaceful lot, so please keep your weapons sheathed. And welcome!
Teach them?
Yes, they are not worthy of the protection of the Tsar.
Exile them! Make them repent!
Patience, brothers and sisters! Patience and tolerance! For ye must accept thy neighbors like the Lord accepts thee, to truly turn their hearts from sin towards the heavenly bliss of true faith. So let us forgive the child, for she knows not the folly of her words. Let us forgive, brothers. Let us pray for the souls of the sinners. And let us forgive the child as the Lord forgives us. Amen.
Silanthius locked us up here a year ago. Yes, the bridge dwellers won't even talk to heretics. But I'll tell you everything I've seen in this place all that year.
A boat is arriving under the cover of fog.
Oh, it's the bridge guard. Silanthius fooled them just like the locals. But unlike them, the bridge guard have guns. Run! There's a way out down here, and there's a boat at the dock.
We also have one, but it's too small for all of us.
Artyom, she's right. Get to the boat. We will rescue her later. Don't worry.
Go! Nati and I can get to your train by ourselves.
Mommy,
hush, hold down. Where is that heretic?
He came by boat during the sermon.
And then what?
Well, he was just there and then kind of disappeared. And just like Father Silanthius said, the man was sent by the devil.
Yeah, I know. I know what Father said. Tell me if you saw where he went.
Well, he just kind of vanished.
I see. All right, God bless you. And I will go look elsewhere. What a dance!
So,
we have to find him, my children!
Artyom, I can't cover you when you're inside. I'm changing position to meet the woman and child. I know you can handle this just fine.
How shall I show you this one now?
stab you, Danya. Could you walk me to the loo? I can handle the corridor, but the ladder... Why are you breathing so hard? Is it you, Boris? You could walk me. I can't wait any longer. Help me out. No, you're not Boris. Look, just walk away.
Artyom, you are like a real ninja. I just kiss you right now. Though I've got to take Katya and Nastya to the Aurora, so see you there. Check the map. Looks like you can roll straight there from your position.
What the fuck was that? A whale? It's fucking huge!
The old man sent me out as a forward sentry, told me that I was to sit tight and under no circumstances look for any action. So I just had a front row seat watching you there. And so you subdue the occupation forces peacefully, with a holy cross and a prayer. Anna has already reported on the cult. How about we trade places? I'd hate to come back to Moscow without even firing once. I was trying to win a girl over from one trader. Tough luck there. Why does everybody else get fun missions? The Colonel does criticize you and all, but he gives you all the best action. Is this his way of showing affection or trying to get you killed? But I have to say it's unfair. I've been dragged out of Moscow and for what? Stalking the furnace and sitting in a bog with a dumb spyglass. Here, though, we do have a chance of finding some loot. There is this plane there. Just leave something for me. I'll have to stay longer, I suspect. The shrimps are giving me trouble, though. I wish I could somehow talk to the catfish into jumping all those water bugs. How did Mowgli talk to the animals, I wonder?
so dumb. I should have landed on that field. We were still flying, and it looked like we could have gone on for some time. And then that damn power line. But really, what difference does that make anyway? We're not getting to Moscow from here, that's for sure. I don't really give a damn. I'm all alone, but the others, they have relatives there. Maybe. It's been 10 years, but I could still be alive. Anyways, we'll have to make ourselves at home here now, since we're alive. The bridge seems like a nice place. At least it's not going to get flooded. We might end up going to Moscow by rail later. We'll have to live and see about that.
Artyom, back from the abyss of NATO
You're
occupation.
You're alive! Impressive, after the horrors Duke told us about. Let's go. Dad's talking to Katya right now. They are so nice. Both Katya and her
Thank
daughter.
Thank you for the information,
and
Katya.
Medical training will
but there is
handy.
One more question I need to ask.
But of course.
What do you know of the occupation forces?
Huh? I'm sorry, I don't quite get what you...
So, you've never seen any foreign army in this area?
No, I haven't seen any army. But we haven't really been to any important places.
I see. Artyom, a moment.
Thank you, Artyom.
Artyom,
if not for you,
desk,
we'd never have escaped that place.
The
they were so busy looking for you. And then Anna picked us up.
Yes, Uncle Artem, thank you. And your wife is great. She's kind and really strong. Thank you, Auntie Anna.
There you go, Artyom. As I always said, you lucked out with me.
We all lucked out with Anna.
Come over here, please. Great job saving them, Artyom. Katya here has provided us with vital information. A mechanic called Crest is hiding in the port. His help is required if we're to fix the Aurora in the foreseeable future. Yermak can't handle the repairs alone. So, once you're ready, go to the port and invite Crest to join us. Then get back ASAP. We'll have to decide what to do about the fanatics on that bridge. Now we know for sure that the bridge is in working order. They crossed it last year when they got here. Well, at least some things are clearer now. But still, so many questions. There might not even be any enemy forces around here at all. They probably garrisoned the key regions only. In any case, we'll learn everything once we reach Yamantau. From the top source. The Moscow government is essentially a local council, to put things in perspective. So, now we just need to figure out how to cross this goddamn bridge.